The following is an excerpt from the feature documentary film, An American Small Town. To watch the entire film and learn how you can support this important film series, visit www.anamericansmalltown.com.
Here's where all the magic happens. Time to give it a double smoke, and stronger smoke the better in. Father started working here in 1960 and he took it over in 66. I started working here in 81. Been here ever since. And essentially the reason we do things the old way is, I don't know, because we're cheap and have bought new equipment. I'm not really sure. It's just the only way we know how to do it, I guess. You know, I wouldn't want it'd be nice to be on a little bit, you know, be a little larger level, but I wouldn't want to be some big huge conglomerate. You get the care for the product when you're doing it on a small, you know, handmade level like this. You're involved with the product, and you're involved with the sauce, and it becomes part of your... there's pride in doing it this way, rather than having, you know, some gigantic factory where it's being churned out over three shifts by a bunch of gigantic machines and things like that. To be honest with you, I never wanted this, and I never really became comfortable and happy with doing it until very recently when I started creating some of my own recipes and having a little bit more ownership of what I'm doing, of the product and that kind of thing. You know, this broth we're making right now is my own recipe.
I think those are the ones you're most proud of, so, but you're still proud of the stuff that's traditional too, that's always been.
This is all I've ever done, and this is the only place I've ever lived, so I can't, it's hard for me to fathom being in a place where, well, you can't get stuff like that, but we hear it pretty much every day, so, you know, it's a privilege to be able to access good sausage, good baked goods. There's a lot of really good food made around this area. Here, you're doing things differently, and, you know, and you're experimenting with things, you're trying to recreate old traditions, but at the same time you're also trying to give it your own twist, and you know, maybe there's some old type of of sausage that nobody around here makes. So, like an example is, we just started recently making Thuringer, which is a traditional German sausage. I get asked for it once in a while, usually by people who were like vacationing in Germany and they had it out there. And I found some recipes and just kind of worked up a version of what it sounded like it's supposed to be. You know, there's a lot to be said for having a close relationship with what you're doing, with the people around you, with knowing more about what's going on. And I know a big thing, people who are city folk, to use the colloquialism, will say, oh, I don't like the small town life because everyone's in your business. And, well, I guess you could say there's some truth to that, but sometimes it's a good thing to have, you know, your neighbor looking out for you. There's a lady here in town who is kind of getting on in her years, and I've known her my whole life, and you know, she lives near my parents, and we all kind of look out for her now. Give her a ride when she needs one, if we see her downtown, that kind of thing. Plus the traffic would drive me up a freaking wall. I don't deal well with that stuff. But my father had a few different jobs when he came here from Switzerland. He worked at a cheese factory for quite a while. The guy who ran this place said, hey, Willie, come on up, and I'll give you a job at my place. I don't know if you offered him more money or what. For whatever reason, it was just kind of a fluke thing that he started working here. And that was 1960. He passed away like within a couple, 3 years. His son-in-law took it over. He passes away like a year or two later. And so the daughter owned it for a short while my dad basically kind of managed it and ran it for her. And then after a very short time, she was like, Willie, what you need to take this, you need to buy the butcher shop for me. I can't do this anymore. And so it kind of sort of fell in his lap to some degree.
Gracias.